Hi guys, welcome to Basics of HVAC, Heating, Ventilation and Air Conditioning. My name is Mujib Khan and today we are going to see refrigeration cycle. Now, today I am going to explain you what is refrigeration cycle in a HVAC system. This is part 2.1. So, before we learn about refrigeration cycle, what is a refrigerant and how does it help your air conditioners? So before we go into brief and see how does the refrigeration cycle works, we need to understand what is a refrigerant. And in order to do so, let us begin. A refrigerant is a substance or a mixture, usually a fluid. It is used in a refrigeration cycle. In most cycles, it undergoes phase transitions from liquid to a gas and back again. Many working fluids have been used for such purpose, depending on their included chemical elements. Now, a refrigerant chemical composition: hydrogen, carbon, chlorine, fluorine. Refrigerant is also known as a freon refrigerant. They are named after as follows: CFCs, HCFCs and HFCs. CFC is a chemical composition of a chlorofluorocarbon. HFC is hydrochlorofluorocarbon, and HFC is hydrofluorocarbon. Properties of a refrigerant. The most common types of refrigerants are azeotropic refrigerant and zeotropic refrigerant. What does it mean? Let it understand. Azeotropic is a mixture of two or more refrigerants whose vapor and liquid phase retain identical composition over a wide range of temperatures. So, a liquid refrigerant can be in its pure state or it can be a mixture of two or more refrigerants. And to be azeotropic refrigerant, it needs to retain its liquid phase identical composition over a wide range of temperatures. Azeotropic refrigerant boils at constant temperature. Typical example of azeotropic mixture can be seen below: R502, R503. These two refrigerants are mixtures of two independent refrigerants, which R22 and R115. R23 or R13. Zeotropic mixture is one whose composition in a liquid phase differs to the vapors in phase. Zeotropic refrigerant do not boil at constant temperature. Typical example of a zeotropic mixture can be seen below: R404A, R407C, R410A. Types of refrigerant. As we discussed before, CFC, HCFC and HFC. So what does this mean? Refrigerants are generally classified into one of the above three substances. Brief explanation of each to help you understand the difference. So let us understand what is the difference between these three types of chemical composition of refrigerants and which one is the one which we are using it right now. CFC refrigerant. These are substances containing carbon, fluorine and chlorine chemicals. The CFC refrigerant is not totally banned from use or production within all countries. The CFC refrigerant, such as one popular R12, has the highest ozone depletion. It is unlikely that many systems exist in operation with this refrigerant. Well, these CFC refrigerants are no longer used and they are totally banned from all the countries. HCFC refrigerant. These are substances containing hydrogen, carbon, fluorine, and chlorine chemical. The HFC refrigerant, such as popular R22, has a potential to damage ozone rating, and it also a greenhouse gas. There are still many systems utilizing this refrigerant. R22, friends, is already banned and is no longer being utilized. But there are still in many countries in existing system, R22 is still being used. So sooner or later, this has to be eliminated. Now, HFC refrigerant. HFC refrigerant, these are substances containing hydrogen, fluorine, and carbon chemicals. The HFC gas used extensively in everyday system. There is no current ban upon these gases, but responsible use and equipment inspection is mandatory. The HFC refrigerant has no ozone depletion potential, including R410A and R134A. With no chlorine in the mix, this is safer for the environment and now being used in place of R22. The main reason for using HFC refrigerant, as you can see, there is no chlorine in the mix. Ozone depletion. Now let us understand what is an ozone depletion and what is the effect of this and why these two refrigerants are eliminated and why HFC refrigerant is being used. Ozone depletion is a decay of the protection ozone layer that filters out harmful UV lights. The UV lights from the sun transfers to our earth with the harmful rays. So the ozone layer protects our earth. Due to this chlorine mixture, the ozone layer has been hampered and there were holes in the ozone layer. A ozone depletion substance can remain in the stratosphere for a long period, causing holes in the layer and allowing harmful UV rays to reach the earth's surface.